A Place for Zero and Mouth Adventure by Angeline, Sparagna, LoPresti, and illustrated by Phyllis, Hornung. Not long ago, Zero lay floating on the calm waters of Central Lake. He can hear the happy cries of the other numbers, 1 through 9, as they played in the meadow. Zero didn't play Add 'em Up because he had nothing to add. He felt he had no place among the other digits. Zero lived in Digitaria, a curious country ruled by King Multiplus and Queen Adeline. Their positive outlook helped the kingdom prosper. Count Infinity, the king's trusted advisor, was the one who shaped all the numbers. When old digits retired, he replaced them with shiny new numerals. Every number knew its place. A 7 was the number of days in a week, and a 5 was the number of points on a star. A 2 was handy for counting the wheels on a bicycle. The 1s were important because Count Infinity added them together to make the other numbers. Every number had a place except 0. Count Infinity had been experimenting when he formed the strange new digit, but 0 meant nothing, and no one was sure what his job would be. King Multiplus declared that no more zeros would be made until they found a purpose for this one. 0 was alone. Nowadays, no one mentioned 0 much. The few times someone tried to count with him, they always ended up with nothing. I need to find my place, 0 thought. He decided to go back to visit the wise old Count Infinity and ask his advice. Count Infinity made incredible things. He made knickknacks, what's-its, and thingamajigs. The most impressive thing he made was an enormous machine, the numerator. The numerator had a vacuum tube on one side and a large curved spout on the other. When Count Infinity placed digits under the tube, they were sucked up with a great clanking and whirling until finally they emerged from the spout with a totally new number. Count Infinity could put in 2 ones to make a bouncy baby 2, or 3 ones to make a roly-poly little 3. As Zero stood shyly in the doorway, Count Infinity looked up and noticed him. "Ah, young Zero," Infinity exclaimed. "You're just in time to help me figure out a better way to make a 1. "What do you mean?" Zero asked. "Well, most numbers are easy to make. I simply pop a handful of 1s into my trusty numerator, making a 1, though that's tricky." "To make a 1," Count Infinity explained, "I spent hours handcrafting it from a special material called integrum." "Why don't you just stick 1, 1 into the numerator?" Zero asked. Count Infinity sighed. "I've tried that, but the numerator adds. You have to put in at least 2 numbers. No 2 numbers that I can think of adds up to..." Count Infinity eyed Zero in a strange way. "Could you put this 1 into the numerator for me?" the count asked. "Just help the 1 stand right under the vacuum tube." As Zero did, he was sucked up into the numerator along with the 1. Zero barely had time to realize what was happening before he was out the other side. Sitting next to him were the old 1 and a shiny new 1. "Wonderful," Count Infinity cried. "We have discovered your additive identity. I bet my binomials that if we add you to any number, we will always come up with the same number. You can help replenish the supply of digits in Digitaria." Zero thanked the count and slowly walked home. He was happy to have a job, but somehow he wasn't satisfied. Ones can make a digit too. He wanted to do something no one else can do. "I still feel that I haven't really found my place," he said to himself. As Zero walked, he had an idea. I wonder what would happen if I were multiplied with another number. Everyone knew that multiplication was a powerful thing, and only the king could use it. Often the product of the multiplied numbers would be too large for anyone to understand. Zero swallowed hard at the boldness of his idea. Then he stood up as straight as a round digit can. I will ask the king, he decided, and set off for the castle. At the gates of the castle, Zero was stopped by two sharp-looking sevens. What kind of number are you? One guard asked. You look like a nine someone squished. Both guards began to laugh. I need to ask the king about multiplication, said Zero. The guards stopped laughing. They looked at each other. Well, said one, you better go right in. Zero entered the castle. He saw King Multiplus and Queen Adeline on their thrones. Crowd of numbers filled the hall, waiting to address them. The five standing next to the Zero asked why he was there. I'm asking the king to multiply me, Zero answered. The five gasped. Other numbers who heard began to whisper. Absolute 9 cents. It's too much. Soon a loud buzz rippled through the hall. What is the meaning of this? King Multiplus boomed, displeased by the growing confusion. It's Zero, Queen Adeline told him, and something about multiplication. Multiplication, the king exclaimed. That is serious business. Let him come forward and explain himself. The room was silent. I would like to be multiplied, Zero told the king. I thought it might help me find my place and purpose. Yes, the king said. I have wondered myself what would happen. He ordered the guards to fetch his multi-tube. The tube was made of solid integrum. We need to find someone who is willing to be multiplied with Zero, the king said. No one moved. Finally, a young one stepped forward. I'll do it, the one said bravely. Together, Zero and the one jumped into the factor end of the tube. All that could be heard was clanking and whirling of the tube. Suddenly, Zero and the one shot out of the other end of the tube. As Zero looked around, he saw beside him a small round figure who looked strangely familiar. Five alive! Exclaimed the king. It's another Zero! The other numbers were speechless. Why, we must try this again, declared the flabbergasted king. This time, we will multiply Zero with a seven. He called for one of his seven guards. The guard's knees shook as he stepped forward. The same thing happened with Zero and the seven. The king laughed and said, Well, Zero, you have your answer. No matter what number we multiply you with, we get zero. This was a big news. The other numbers chattered excitedly. But Zero said, Now there are more zeros with no real place. The one patted Zero on the back. Zero was glad to have a friend at the time like this. I want to make new numbers that no one has ever seen before, Zero said. Sire, what number do you get if you add 1 to 9? It was one of those questions that no one ever asked. The king coughed. As anyone knows, anything bigger than 9 is many, he said. We don't think about 1 plus 9 because there is no digit for a number that big. Zero looked at the one standing next to him. He rubbed his eyes. Together, he and the one looked like this, 1 0. Sire, he cried, look at us. We can make a new number to represent what you get when you add 1 and 9. The king scratched his chin. Zero asked 9 ones to stand together. Sire, if we ask one more to this group, we could use a zero to show that all those ones have moved over to the next place. When I stand in this place next to my friend one as a zero, I can represent zero ones, but he now represents 9 plus 1. I like your thinking, Zero, the king said, but he whispered, I can't call the new number 9 plus 1. Quick, think of a new name. Zero whispered back, this new number will attend to a lot of business. Could we call it attend? The king couldn't hear Zero very well, so in a loud voice he said, I proclaim that this new number be called a 10. The numbers all loved it. Hooray for 10! Hooray for 10! They cheered. The numbers crowded around Zero and asked if they could stand beside him. Zero gave each digit a turn, and soon they were making wonderful new numbers like 20, 30, 60, and 90. Before long, they were standing next to each other in different combinations to make all kinds of new numbers. 3, 2, 4, 7, 8, 9, and so on and on. Big numbers didn't seem quite so scary anymore. When the excitement calmed down, Zero felt someone tugging at his arm. What about me? Asked a small voice. Is it my turn to stand next to you? The new little Zero asked. I'm sorry, Zero said. Two zeros standing next to each other still equal nothing. The little Zero looked so sad that the brave one and Zero each put an arm around her. Suddenly, Zero had a thought. Look, sire, he called to the king. What do we look like? King said slowly, why, you look like a new number, bigger than any I've ever seen, bigger even than the new number 90. Zero said proudly, we can represent what you get when you have 10 tens. Splendid, exclaimed the king. Soon, all the other digits were clamoring to stand next to the two zeros. They made numbers like 500 and 700. A nine got so excited when he helped make the number 900 that he almost fell over. In the middle of the excitement, Zero noticed Count Infinity beaming at him. Well, Zero, the count smiled. Did you find what you were looking for? Zero nodded. I just wanted to mean more than nothing, he said. And now, I think I finally found my place. From then on, Zero played Adam up as happily as everyone else. The end.
Hello, I hope you enjoyed today's math story. So the next part is for teachers and parents. And I'm going to go over with you are some math standards and the grade levels that touch on these standards so you know when to use this story. Also, if you click on the below link, you'll see some resources that I found online that are free, and that way you can continue on with the learning.
The first standard is in kindergarten, and so you'll see the letter K in front, which represents the grade level. Then after that, you'll see the letter NBT, which represents the domain of number base 10. So when we say domain, it's kind of like the category. And then after that, you'll see letters of A, B, C, etc. That represents the subcategories, and then also numbers, which will go into a little bit more details of the subcategories. So in the kindergarten, the students will be composing and decomposing numbers from 11 to 19 into 10 ones and some further ones, so which they will do a lot of grouping of tens. In grade one, so same domain is the number base 10. One of the things that students will do is count to 120, starting at any number less than 120. Another standard for grade one is to add up to 100 using one digits and two digit numbers. And again, doing a lot of clustering of multiples of 10. The third standard in B5 is to give any two digit number and mentally find 10 more or 10 less without having to count. So what we call is subitizing, which they recognize groupings of 10 so they can take away 10 or add 10 to it.
And then the last one in that grade one is to subtract multiples of 10 in the range of 10 to 90 using concrete models or drawings. So they'll do a lot of groupings of that and drawings of that. In grade two, they will still be under the domain of number base 10. They will take three-digit numbers and represent in ones, tens, and hundreds. A second standard is counting within 1,000 and being able to skip in units of fives, tens, and hundreds. A third standard is being able to read and write numbers to 1,000 using base 10 numerals, being able to skip by tens. The fourth one is fluently adding and subtracting within 100 using strategies based on place values. So similar to the previous one, but now it's for 100 bases. And then the last one is being able to add four two-digit numbers using strategies based on place values and properties of operations. So as you can see,
in grade level two,
they will do a lot of adding, subtracting of large numbers in units of five, tens, hundreds, and up to the number 1,000. In grade level three, under the domain of number base 10 still, students will be fluently adding and subtracting within 1,000 using strategies and algorithm based on place values, the properties of operations, and the relationship between adding and subtracting, and then also being able to multiply the one-digit whole numbers in multiples of 10 and ranging from 10 to 90. In grade four, still under the domain of numbers and base 10, students will be able to fluently add and subtract multiple digit whole numbers using the standard algorithm, so which is the paper and pencil, being able to do those things. And then finally, in grade five, still under the domain of number and base 10, students are going to be able to explain the patterns of the numbers of zeros of the product when multiplying a number by power of 10 and explaining the patterns in the placement of the decimal when the decimal is multiplied or divided. So they'll be working with a lot of decimals. Now, as we get to grade level six and up, they don't have the same
domain because it will change.
These are the standards for the number base 10. So at any of the grade levels, when you come to this domain, you can implement this story into your lesson.
Goodbye. We'll see you at the next math story.